the people that most inspire me are fans, are just people going to parties. Together we kind of create the magic. It's kind of like a cycle of energy that goes from the crowd to the DJ and back to the crowd, and you kind of together reach this place that you could have never gotten to by yourself. One of the earliest memories I had relating to music was probably listening to crazy free jazz music in our living room at 6 o'clock in the morning. My dad, he was really into that sort of music, and it was just noise to me. It was random and it was frightening. At the same time, it was fascinating. My first introduction to music was through my father. He was a musical journalist. We had a huge record collection. There was always music playing in the house. So I was never someone who learned to play an instrument. I'm a total autodidact. Also with my synthesizers, I learned everything myself. I'm not really able to read notes or even play an instrument, but I have a trained hearing because I've always listened to music, and I think I'm pretty good at translating feeling into music and vice versa, music into feeling, which is something you need to do when you're a DJ or a producer. The best thing about my life as a professional DJ and producer is being exposed to many different cultures, countries, people, to feel that there's so much love everywhere if you look for it and if you're open to it. So the amount of amazing people from totally different backgrounds that I've met around the world, and many of them don't believe in the same things that I do, but yet we found a way to connect to each other and share amazing times with each other. I mean, once you strip away the surface, underneath the surface, to realize that people are all the same. Everybody wants the same thing. Everybody wants to have a peaceful life, a fulfilling life, and the fighting is completely unnecessary, and that we're more similar than that we're different from each other. My personal musical journey from my childhood to becoming actually a musician was full of detours. When I was 16, I was working as a barkeeper at the local bar, and there was a DJ who showed me how to work the decks, and I was immediately hooked, like so many other DJs. And the next probably 10 years, I just spent, as a hobby DJ, playing in little bars, playing small warehouse parties, and making mixtapes. And I sent one of these mixtapes to a Red Bull for the Red Bull Music Academy, and they accepted me to the 2002 edition. And we had 2 weeks of lessons, inspiration, parties, and I was surrounded by people who are all super into music. And from that moment on, I was like, wow, it's possible to have a career in this. It's possible to shape your life around music. And from that moment on, my whole focus was just on becoming a musician of some sort. That for me was the defining moment where I saw, wow, there's more in that than just a hobby. I can turn this into a career. And when I moved to Amsterdam, the scene was much bigger than where I grew up, which was in East Germany. Next thing you know, a few years later, I was doing nothing else but music.